This one mod can improve your motorcycle's acceleration, handling, ride quality, and even your braking power. Too good to be true? Let's find out.
This is a forged motorcycle rim made by MOS Motor. You might notice it's light enough I can easily carry it around with one hand. In today's video, we're going to be talking about why forged rims are better than cast rims for your motorcycle or scooter. I'm Adrian from YouMotorcycle. I make videos for people who want to learn more about motorcycling, so let's get right into it. Most motorcycle wheels are made of aluminum, but there are two main different ways that motorcycle wheels are made. One is called casting, one is called forging, and depending on which kind of wheel you get, it will greatly impact the performance, the ride quality, handling, and other characteristics of your vehicle. So let's talk about that. So the first most common way of making motorcycle wheels is called casting. Cast wheels are made by heating up aluminum and then pouring it into a ready-made cast or template. And then boom, you get your motorcycle rim at the end of the process. The thing is that a casted rim on your bike is going to be both heavier and weaker, so more likely to get bent or damaged in some sort of way. And that's because casting during that process, there's a chance to get little bubbles inside of those bubbles can create weakness points. You get it. Forging though is very different. It's less common, and forged wheels, yes, they're still made of aluminum, but the process is really different. Imagine a big chunk of aluminum and we're heating it up to the point where then we can just hammer it into shape and then we can just cut out the notches and you get something like this left over. Looks pretty good, right? And yeah, it's a lot more work, but at the end of the day, it gives you both a lighter wheel and a stronger one. That will be very helpful. You'll see why. First though, I just want to make the differences between the two processes crystal clear. Forging is like when you see some medieval movie and there's a blacksmith and he's making like a sword. Blacksmith takes it out of the fire and he's just hammering the heck out of this sword. That's forging. Casting it is like your grandma and she's got her little cookie cutter pieces and she puts it in the cookie cutter mold and then boom, you get your gingerbread cookies at the end. That's kind of a really overly simplified version of the difference between casting and forging. Not very technical, but at least it's an easy picture for you to imagine in your mind. The real question is, are forged wheels that much better to be worth the extra effort and let's face the extra price versus your cookie cutter cast alloy wheel for your motorcycle or your Vespa? Firstly, this is the weight of the original OEM wheel. This is the weight of the MOS Motor wheel. That's the difference. And it might not sound like much, but this is what it is as a percentage. And that does make a big difference because it all comes down to unsprung weight and inertia. Unsprung mass refers to everything below the suspension. That's your wheels, your brakes, drivetrain components, etc. And have you ever really noticed that really fast animals and animals that are known for darting quickly and being able to change direction quickly, like a leopard or cheetah, they have kind of skinny legs and littler feet, less unsprung weight. Versus if you look at something like a hippo and elephant, relative to their size, they might be fast, but they're not fast relative to how big they are. Again, they have a lot of unsprung weight. They're not known for being able to dart around too quickly. That's why. Same thing applies to our bikes. So forget the animal kingdom for a second. Let's get back on our motorcycles and get focused here. If you think about your tires as they're rolling forward, right, they're going over different grooves in the pavements, ripples in the pavement, whatever it is. Every time it's hitting a bump, something unsmooth, uneven, whatever, it creates a small change in direction. The heavier the weight is, the harder that change in direction is. The lighter the weight is, the easier that is for your suspension to handle. So when you have less unsprung weight, whether you have a smooth piece of pavement or a rippled one, your ride will be smoother. This can be especially noticeable if you're on one of those roads where the asphalt's been torn up and you just have the exposed cement down the way, or if you're on a gravel thing or whatever. Places where there's a lot of friction for your tire. If you have a heavier unsprung weight, you're gonna feel that a lot more as you're riding. But if you have less unsprung weight, it'll feel a lot smoother. The other, and I think more important reason why unsprung weight matters is when it comes to the motorcycle, or in this case, Vespa's a point of inertia or moment of inertia. So if I asked you to put this on an axle and spin it, you could probably spin this wheel with just two fingers, right? But if you watch a game show like The Price is Right, where they have that big wheel that they have to spin, those guys will put both hands and their whole backs into spinning that wheel. Why? It's because it's a heavier wheel. It's got more unsprung weight. So what does that mean? It takes a lot more energy to start that wheel spin. And it also takes a lot more energy if you wanted to stop the bigger, heavier, more unsprung mass from spinning. So if we apply this to a cast wheel versus a forged wheel, the heavier cast wheel is going to need more energy to make it start spinning, more energy to stop it from spinning, and more energy to change directions. Versus this forged wheel is going to have better acceleration, better braking, and better handling characteristics. So it's a win. All right, so now I've had the MOS Motor forged wheels for some time. It's time to talk about quality, fit, and finish, installation, and whether or not my actual riding experience lives up to all of that science and physics talk from before. First, fit and finish, I was impressed, my first impressions for sure. I also like that before I even got it, I could pick from I think four different colors that the product came in, but I'm not an expert on rims, so I took it to people who see hundreds if not thousands of rims every year. I took it to two different shops, Cycle Works in Toronto to have the tires mounted, and Moto Motori to have the tires balanced.
At Carlos Place Moto Motori, we're gonna see how balancing the MOS forged rims are doing.
Carlo, how are we doing over here, man?
Fantastic, buddy. Yeah. Just balancing them. Everything looks good.
Yeah. Would you say that they are as good, better, or worse than the Vespa stock OEMs?
Normal as usual, man.
Okay.
Just like any other rim.
Awesome.
Lighter, obviously.
Time out, because I don't want to put words in anyone's mouth, but there is a chance that some of these techs who really liked the rims at the beginning of the video may or may not feel the same by the end of the video. Stay tuned, you'll see what I mean.
All the technicians that I showed the wheels to, they were impressed. They said they were great, no nitpicking issues, and they don't sell these products, right? So it's not like they were trying to sell me something. They just were guys. I said, here, what do you think of this? And they all said, looks pretty good. Installation was typical of any other rim. In the example of Vespa GTS, you remove the exhaust. Then the swing arm. Then the wheel itself. Install the new MOS Motor forged wheel. And put the swing arm and the exhaust back on. For the front tire, you'll want to have the Vespa on the center stand and jack up the front end a bit. And remove the five bolts that hold that front wheel in place, remove the OEM wheel, and install the forged wheel. So how does it actually ride, and can you actually feel a difference? Well, let's find out.
New tires are installed, and you might be wondering, how do we actually test to just see how good these forged wheels really are? I don't have access to a race trap. I don't have time to switch tires back and forth. But what I do have is access to an identical second bike.
Okay, just got in from test riding both bikes a bunch of times, and I learned a whole bunch, which I will share with you. First, I just want to say thank you to MOS Motor. Thank you, because it's been a really cool learning experience for me. So yeah, let me share with you guys what I learned.
Well, acceleration had a noticeable improvement with the lighter weight forged wheels. It wasn't huge, wasn't substantial, but it was definitely noticeable. Rolling on throttle, especially from a stop, it felt like the engine wasn't working as hard. Like I was getting more juice for the same amount of squeeze out of my motor, so that was pretty cool.
The second thing was something that I noticed organically going over rougher asphalt that wasn't like super, super smooth. Like you can kind of feel some of that texture, some of that friction on the forged wheels. It's like someone took the dial of softness and just cranked it up and just really softened it. It's a much more premium feel on the forged wheels, so that was pretty cool. The third thing we should talk about is brakes. Braking is not something that I actually tested. And the reason why is both bikes had basically brand new Michelin City Grip tires on them. Braking though, they had different brake pads on them. They had different wear on the rotors on them. I felt like I couldn't give you an honest comparison on braking. But again, theoretically, it takes less energy to stop a lighter wheel from spinning than a heavier one. So you should have shorter stopping distance, better braking power with the forged wheels.
Lastly, we've got handling, which is kind of tricky because at first I actually preferred the cast wheels, but things were not set up for a fair fight. So the PSIs were all off, I adjusted that. Then I realized with the top case, it was adding a bunch of weight up high and behind the rear axle, got rid of that.
And the feeling of the bikes were very, very, very close. After about 2 hours of riding, once I had started to really warm up and break in those brand new tires, it felt just as good, if not slightly better on the forged wheels.
But honestly, at the speeds I was doing compared to the improvement in acceleration and ride quality, the difference is not as noticeable. So anyway, if you found my video informative, hitting that like button would be a huge, huge help to me. You guys like my video, really helps me drive a lot more views.
And if you're wondering what did happen with that MOS rim, well, the rear one did bend. Yes, I totally did hit a pothole. I've hit a lot of potholes over 15 years. I've never had a rim bend on me before, but MOS has definitely stepped in and stepped up and said, hey, we think this is a rare freak occurrence, so we are sending you a free rim to replace it. So that was pretty cool. So I will be doing a long-term review where I'll let you guys know just how well the rims have held up after a couple thousand more miles. Hit subscribe if you want to see that. As always, ride safe, but have fun. Peace.